Tinkerbell the dog.
And I'm her little sister, Belle.
And this is our podcast.
Fierce, fabulous fluff, talking about stuff. Gossip Pups. Fierce, fabulous fluff, talking about stuff. Gossip Pups.
Happy FURiday, everyone!
I'm Tinkerbelle.
And I'm Belle.
And welcome to Gossip Pups,
episode one.
Woof, 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 we made it!
This is it. I cannot believe we are here. Thank you, everyone, for listening in to our first episode. This is our first official episode, and I cannot be more excited.
New year and new fun.
Yes. And so we're going to be talking every week, every FURiday, about pop culture and pup culture and just everything that
and
you want to hear.
Pup culture.
Yes. So here we go. I'm so excited. But before we start, I just want to, you know, get a little information about, you know, how your new year's going, Belle, and everything. Just let me know.
Great. Well, I'm so excited because I just found out that I booked another job, so I'll be on set next week, and
excellent.
I can't tell you much about it, but hopefully next FURiday, I'll be able to tell you so much about my set day and share some photos and behind the scenes info and
what
some
exactly
gossip.
Are you doing? Is it like modeling? Is it acting? Is it the stage?
It's acting and modeling.
Ooh, and is it on camera or...
Well, yes.
Okay.
But
so it's
I
not
can't
live.
Say more.
It's not a runway
no,
or something.
It's not SNL.
Oh, okay. It's SNL?
No, it's not. But I wish it was again. I can't wait.
Oh, yes.
What are you up to, Tink?
So actually, well, you know what I'm up to. We are heading to a travel partnership this year. The first travel partnership of 2023. Can you believe it?
I'm so excited because this is one of our favorite places ever.
Yes, we are actually heading to Boston for, you know, a Traveling Tink partnership to the hotel that we just cannot get enough of.
And they bring us breakfast in bed.
Yes, and champagne. And of course, you know, we get to run around the entire lobby and just enjoy all the amenities. And of course, I love Boston, so.
Yes, me too. That was one of my places that my first arrival I got to go to with you, and it was so much fun, and we went to a baseball game and had a great time.
Yeah, so I don't know what we're going to do this time around the city, but we'll find something. We always find things and photo opportunities and everything, and of course we're going to be making amazing content and TikToks, so I just cannot wait. And of course I cannot wait to just relax.
So next FURiday, we're going to have so much to tell everybody.
Yes, a lot to talk about, and of course you can keep up with us on Instagram though and TikTok, and you can see all of our adventures in real time. But that's about it.
Let's get right to the pop culture, Tink.
Oh my goodness, there is so much going on this week, but we have to start with the news of the morning, of this FURiday morning, and that is that Kanye West had a secret wedding with a mystery woman.
Yes.
Can you
I
believe
heard
this?
She's actually the designer of Yeezy.
Yes, I heard. And her name is Bianca Censori.
Apparently, she's a lookalike for Kim.
Oh, really? I did not know that because apparently she's blonde now. She used to be brunette, but now she's blonde. But yes, they got married and they had a sort of wedding ceremony. Though we're told it doesn't appear they filed a marriage certificate to make it legal. So I just think that that is very interesting. And they were spotted. Guess what? They were spotted at the Waldorf Astoria in Beverly Hills.
Wait. So he went from missing to married?
Missing to married. Yes, that is what is happening here.
So I guess he wasn't missing.
No.
And when did they stop looking for him?
I don't know, because the last thing I heard was that he was missing. Everyone said, oh, where's Kanye? Where's Kanye? He's missing. And then all of a sudden now he's at the Waldorf and And dining married. At the Waldorf and married.
And married.
From missing to married.
To a designer. That's perfect for him, actually.
I mean, I hope that he's just happy. Maybe, you know, Bianca is keeping him on, like, a better track. And, you know, I'm just hoping for peace and harmony for him. Because it's been a very, very just awful year for him. And there's just been a lot of issues and a lot of controversy and a lot of, you know, hurting people's feelings. And
Kanye just says things, I think, that he doesn't think first, and that might be the problem, but I'm glad he's found and hopefully
yes, and this
married.
Is not the podcast where we're going to get too deep into, you know, racial injustices and problems with all of that, but it's just been a very, very dark time for Kanye, and I hope it's brighter in the future.
And maybe Kim will accept her and be friends.
Oh, I highly doubt that. But anyway, let's move on to our next story. Now, this is a little bit of sad news, and it's that Lisa Marie Presley has died at age 54 following a cardiac arrest. Now, I cannot believe that this happened.
Belle. Oh my gosh.
Because she was just at the Golden Globes.
She did act a little off at the interview for the Golden Globes.
I know. I saw that when we were, you know, watching the Golden Globes on our couch together.
Yes. I didn't know something was wrong, though. I didn't know. That's so sad.
It's just terrible. And, you know, for Priscilla to have to make the statement, it is just heart-wrenching. And, you know, I just can't believe this tragic death.
And it's kind of the end of Elvis, because she was his sole heir to everything of his child.
I don't know what's going to happen. I mean, I just am sending love out to the entire family, and just rest in peace, Lisa Marie Presley.
Rest in peace.
Yes.
Sorry.
Yes.
We didn't get to meet her.
No, we did not get to meet her. Terrible.
That would have been amazing.
I know. But maybe Priscilla.
Oh, yeah.
One day.
That'll be fun.
That would be really fun.
Yeah.
So let's move on to some more happier news. Now, this news is just amazing. I am gushing over it this week. And that is that Caroline Manzo and Alex McCord are starring on The Real Housewives Ultimate Girls Trip Season 4.
Wait, does that mean there'll be lots of fights?
I don't know about fights, but I am just a huge fan, especially of Alex McCord. And I know that I showed you a couple episodes of the first and second seasons of New York Housewives.
Yes, because I didn't know who they were. So you said, let's watch. And I watched and I was like, whoa.
Yes, and just, you know, oof. Alex brought this specific energy to The Real Housewives from the beginning. And, you know, she has not been around since. She moved to Australia. She became a psychologist, I believe. And she lives there with her family there. And for her to come back now after so long, I am just so excited to see what happens.
I'm excited because The New York Housewives was really boring. It was getting so bad that they needed to do something, and I guess this is what they did. They pulled from someone from the past back.
No, actually, this is not Real Housewives of New York, though. This is Real Housewives Ultimate Girls Trip. So she's going on the girls trip to Morocco, season 4. So right now, there was the last season that aired was the Berkshires one with Dorinda at the house. And now this
that was great.
Yes, that was excellent. Now there's a season 3.
Dorinda's a friend of yours.
Yes, she is. Now there's a season 3 where it's going to be coming out soon, but then they just announced season 4. So season 4 is where we're going to meet Alex after so long.
Amazing.
So that's going to be great. That's great TV. Going to be on Peacock. And I'm very excited about that.
Yeah, I can't wait to watch.
Mm-hmm.
That'll be a great popcorn and soda night to sit there.
Yes, it will, Belle. And maybe a little champagne, of course, or wine. Oh, gotta love my wine.
Yeah, I'm not old enough to drink it.
No, you're not. So now we have another big story. Can you believe this? That TV insiders buzz that Rachael Ray's daytime talk show is ending.
No.
Now, I cannot believe this because Rachael Ray, I have actually worked with her a couple years ago.
Yes, to launch
to promote her dog food.
Nutrish.
Yes, Nutrish. So I am, you know, I'm a big fan of Rachael Ray, and she was so nice to me, and we took photos together, and, you know, I definitely really enjoyed Nutrish. It was delicious. So I just cannot believe it's about an end of an era.
So maybe she's just going to stay in Italy now? Because I think she lives in Italy, too.
Yes, I think so. It says that her show is ending, and this will be the last season, as speculated. And I don't really, I mean, I can understand, though, there are a lot of new daytime talk shows that I feel like are more, you know, current and with the times right now, like especially Kelly Clarkson.
She cooks a lot.
Yes, and not that cooking is bad, but, but I just feel like the show is, it is dated. It feels, you know, it feels older than, you know, Kelly Clarkson. She's just kind of taking over the daytime show, you know, times, and Drew Barrymore. There's so many new shows out there.
Jennifer Hudson, too.
Yes.
Maybe,
And, you know, maybe she needs a break. Like, maybe she's done.
She's done it so long that I think she just wants to have her days free.
Yeah, and I don't blame her for, you know, wanting to change it up, maybe, or just do something different.
Go shopping.
It's a lot of work.
Go out to lunch. Go shopping and have fun.
Enjoy Italy.
Oh. Yeah.
Amazing.
Did you see her house in Italy?
Yes, I actually saw she had a little tour one day, and it was
beautiful.
Amazing. If you guys want to see her house in Italy, just go on YouTube, Google
beautiful.
It. It is gorgeous. The views.
Breathtaking. I would love to live there. I haven't been out of the United States yet, but someday I will.
Yes, you will, Belle.
Maybe I'll go there.
We are planning a trip overseas, and it will be incredible. I will bring you everywhere that I know. I know I've been so many places, and you've been nowhere.
So rude.
Soon, I promise.
I'm a true American pup.
Yes, you are a true American pup, and I'm a cultured pup.
Yes.
So I feel like that was a lot of information. I mean, we touched on a really great subjects, and I just wanted to talk about one more story before we get to pup culture, Belle. Are you ready for pup culture?
Ready.
So before that, I just want to share how I thought it was touching, so touching at the Golden Globes, that Selena Gomez brought her 9-year-old sister Gracie to the ceremonies.
Wasn't that amazing?
It was so great. And it just reminded me of me and you. And, you know, when I'm nominated for my Golden Globe, I will definitely be bringing you, Belle.
She's the best big sister. And it's amazing to see how Gracie looks up to her. And she's so protective of Gracie and made sure that if she was nervous in front of the camera, she said, just hold on to me. And it was amazing, and so happy, and
her dress was adorable. It was like this gold sparkly dress, and of course Selena looked incredible as well.
Selena's beautiful.
Yes.
I wish to meet Selena one day.
Yes, we will be meeting her one day. I just know it. I have this feeling it's going to happen, and it's going to be incredible.
But the red carpet is, there's like thousands of photographers taking pictures and videos of you. So it is a little, if you don't know better, you can get very nervous.
Yes.
But it's really fun experience. I love it.
I live for it.
And I think Gracie liked it too.
I think she did. She was smiling. She had a great time. I mean, what is there not to like? Anyway, Belle, can we do some pup culture?
Yes, pup culture time.
Woo-hoo. Here we go.
So, first on the list is Northwest treated her dogs to an indoor meal after that whole garage backlash. Because everybody was saying that the dogs lived in the garage.
Oh.
So rude.
I mean, well, that's not rude. I'm glad that they got an indoor meal, finally.
But they
should
be indoors all the time. It's two Pomeranians, Sushi and Saki, and they apparently had a homemade meal, even better, from the kitchen. And they got to enjoy it, and everybody came over and, of course, did photo ops with them eating in the house. But what are your thoughts? Do you really think they live in the garage?
Honestly, as a celebrity myself, I don't think they live in the garage. I think maybe they stay in the garage at some points. But, I mean, we are not ones to judge. Like, I just feel like there is no true evidence that they live in the garage.
Well, here's the other thing. We don't know what the garage actually looks like. It can look like a mansion in that garage.
Yes, it can be. And it could be heated and cooled, and they might have, you know,
a play area.
They might have recliners, who knows what
exactly.
They have.
Exactly. So just because they say it's the garage doesn't mean it's a garage.
And just because you see one video of dogs in a garage does not mean they live in the garage. And I think that we as a society should not judge based on one TikTok video.
Yes, because we know they're not always real.
Yes, just reality is distorted, especially on social media, everyone. So calm down.
But I'm happy.
But I'm glad they had a home-cooked meal.
In Kim's kitchen.
Yes, thank you, Kim.
Fun. And then the next pup culture.
Also, I want to say one more thing, because I do see it, how it says Christmas time for the dogs. So, Christmas time for the dogs, if there's a million people over their house, their mansion, I mean, there's a lot of things that could go wrong. Someone could step on the dogs. They're very small, just like us. I don't like being around all these people sometimes, you know, and we don't know if someone leaves the door open, the dog gets out, then a coyote gets you.
Oh,
you just don't know.
So you think they only got put in the garage for Christmas?
Yes, around the Christmas time. Maybe they had tons of people over. And so they took a video of them in their little, you know, sanctuary.
I honestly think the garage is a beautiful apartment.
It probably is, though. Anyway, we'll move on. But I just wanted to give my little, just a little bit more of my thoughts.
So more pup culture for everyone. This is really fun. So, I'm sure you've all heard of The Whale, the movie.
Yes, The Whale. I've heard of it.
So, for the premiere, Brenan Fraser, who is the star of The Whale, he brought as his date on the red carpet his Yorkie.
Oh!
And they shared the spotlight on the red carpet. Brenan Fraser and his little Yorkie. And he's a teacup Yorkie.
Oh, so around
cute.
The same size as us.
Yes.
Oh, are there any pictures of this?
Yes, if you go online, you can see some. In fact, you can see them getting out of the car together. And she's so tiny, the Yorkie. She's so cute.
Oh, this is just heartwarming.
And The Whale. I can't wait to see that movie. It looks fabulous.
I have not seen it, obviously. And I hope that we get to see it at some point.
Maybe in Boston.
Maybe.
But look, she's tiny.
Oh, I see the photos.
And she's a girl because she has pink on.
Oh, she
well,
must
that
have...
doesn't mean anything, but I think
okay,
she's a girl.
Okay, well, they must have really enjoyed that moment. I mean, to see the screening. Oh, a date at The Whale. That is just heartwarming.
And the other thing is it was raining. So they were carrying an umbrella to keep Brandon and the puppy covered.
Oh, that is... so cute.
So the puppies are stepping out this week.
Yes. That is so great.
Go pups. Go pups.
Is that all the pup culture you have?
Besides you and I? Yeah. That's for today.
That was great pup culture.
I know. I love pup culture.
Yes, you do. Oh, so I think
we have to tell everyone.
Yes.
Make sure to listen. Download, like, subscribe, and give 5 paws up.
Oh, so we're done, Belle?
I don't know if we're done, but I just wanted to tell everyone that.
I guess we are done. I mean, we did our pop culture, and I think that this is the end of the official first episode, Belle.
I hope we did okay. 5 paws up?
5 paws up to me, of course. Maybe even 6, 7, 8, 9, or 10.
I hope everyone has a great weekend.
Yes, have a great weekend. XOXO.
Woof.
Fear. Fierce Fabulous Fluff, talking about stuff. Gossip Pups, Fierce Fabulous Fluff, talking about stuff. Gossip Pups.